Thank you. Thank you. Muhammad lived and wrote the Quran, he knew that he would, his image and his reputation would continue on forever. That's why he hurried up and wrote the Muslim law, so that that law would benefit the people. You see that? So when he done that, it's pretty much, he did that a lot sharper than the Christians. The Christians didn't have that opportunity to do that. They didn't realize that Christ was going to be forever. So the Muslim law is sharper, harder, and more fair, and has more rights to it than the Christian law. But now here we are, and we transcended the wooden cross. We transcended the iron cross. Now we're into the plastic cross and the technology cross. We've got a mansion here that's going to exist for eternity, forever. Anything he says is going to continue on as God.
Okay.
It hasn't got a question of like or right or wrong or anything. It's going to be that way.
Okay.
They're going to study every damn thing that I have ever said, every move I have ever made. They're going to rehash it, look at it, and go over and over, and they're going to rub all the paint off it. So what we need to do is not do acts and movies, but to do commands and laws, to make laws like I make a law. Everybody wants for public opinion. Except me.
Okay.
I'm convicted, so I'm already dead.
Yes.
You know, the dead doesn't care when you vote for them. So we're not looking for votes. We're not looking for popularity. We're not looking to be either stars or entertainers. We're not looking for anyone else's opinions or ideas. We're looking for what is. And zero. The Japanese call that eternal
wisdom. It's from an eternity. Can I tell us when you're collecting?
We're looking at eternity, and we're wasting what little time I've got left to keep that door open. In other words, I'm holding the bridge.
Yep.
I'm holding the door open.
Okay.
So the war train that they waste by holding me down with some midship little idiot that wants to play like something to impress some girl.
Right.
Because like his mother, taught him to be a little girl himself, and all them little girl things is the matriarch is Eleanor Roosevelt. Freed Mandela from prison.
Yeah.
Made him the king of Africa. Because she opened up the legs to young women when Theodore Roosevelt didn't have anything on the bottom of the wheelchair. You see it?
Yep.
That was Pell Mall, that was living, Tobacco Road, that was CC Camps, that was
Frequency to communicate to ourselves.
Okay.
The truth.
Right.
And whether we get it or not, it's going to be there. Because it's coming, because all the dead are falling away. They call themselves alive, and all the living, they call themselves dead. The order of that one don't need a head man.
Mm.
I've got a thing that the head dead man don't need a head man. You need an intelligence.
Mm.
An intelligence. All those who want to survive will do what they're supposed to do. But the information that you get must be valid.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for example, what you tell on military frequency.
Oh.
There will be no more using of wax. Wax is outlawed. There'll be no more using it underarm deodorants. Underarm deodorants are outlawed. There'll be no more use of toilet paper.
Okay.
All these little creature comforts that we have, you've got to give them up.
Oh.
If you don't give them up, that's what's destroying the water. On the television, they got these things that gone and altered, this claims all the dirt. This takes all the dirt. You got these powerful things, these chemicals that you're making, and you're cleaning your sink real clean.
Mm-hmm.
But it's killing all the fish in the water.
Right.
It's killing the ocean. You got tons of this garbage going up into the ocean. You've got to stop that.
Right.
You've got to go up to take your army and engineers, and you go up to where the water starts in the mountains. You go up to the hood, the monk's hood, that you can't run out and start chopping the trees down. Put that water back. Then you go to all those artificial rivers and start putting back in.